En esta nueva sección de Thalía NFTs voy a tener conversaciones semanales con los expertos de este mundo. Conversaciones acerca de la comunidad Web3, NFTs y fashion, arte, música y mucho más. Acompáñame en este espacio para educarnos y crecer juntos en esta nueva realidad. Bellecísimas, ¿cómo están? ¡Ey, bellecísimas! ¡Qué gusto estar aquí con ustedes en estos espacios, arrancando uno más, one more space. I'm so excited. We're building this community together. Estamos arrancando esa comunidad que está llena de amor, de pasión, de cariño. Y bueno, hoy vamos a tener algunos invitados muy, muy interesantes, porque son invitados ahora sí que de haute couture, del mundo del fashion, pero del fashion digital. Así que todos estaremos muy contentos hablando de el estilismo y el fashionismo. Bellezas, mi co-host Rox está dejando entrar a todos los invitados el día de hoy. ¿Cómo estás, mi Rox?
I'm too surprised. It's like snowing here in Canada.
No, no. Uh-huh.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you? Thank you for inviting us. This is George with Colton Rain.
Hi, George. How are you?
I'm fantastic. Thank you so much for inviting us. I'm actually with Andy Griffiths, who is our head of marketing with me. We're sitting together, so on one speaker.
GM.
Hey, so seriously, thank you for being here. We're like so happy to talk about something that we are so passionate about, that is fashion. And yeah. What else that, you know, on top of that is in Web3 that we are absolutely obsessed with. So tell us a little bit about you guys. And by the way, we're gonna go like, you know, English, and then sometimes we're gonna do a little Spanish or Spanglish, so you feel like that's gonna happen in that space. Okay, this is the space that all of it is part of it. Okay,
it's all good. We're all cool. Whatever language you want to throw at us, it's all good. I can do a little bit of Mandarin, Chinese.
No,
I can
do come
a little
on.
Bit of Italiano.
All right, all right. Let's uh-huh. do some Chinese.
Okay. Ni hao.
Ni hao.
I see.
That's
no.
good.
No, wow. Something different. Something more like challenging. Come on.
Okay. You can say 大家好. That means hello, everyone.
大家好.
Perfect.
Oh, I like that. 大家好.
That's amazing.
Okay, yo no puedo.
No puedo.
Oye, tachaha. Oye, so tell us about you guys. Come on, we want to hear a little.
Oh my God, this is freaking amazing. I love it. all right, let's talk a little bit about Colton Rain and what we're trying to do within Web3. So my name is George. I'm the founder of Colton Rain. I've been a creative director in fashion for the past 18 years. So I started my career in New York. I work for brands like DKNY, John Varvatos. I helped launch Theory in New York from 2004 to 2010. Got recruited to Milano. Worked for Costume Nationale as design director for men's and women's. Did runway for the past 10 years. I worked at Cerruti in Paris, another maison.
Ooh la la, mon amour, mais tu es incroyable. Qu'est-ce qu'il y a? Pourquoi tu es incroyable?
Wow, the French is coming in. I love it. So yeah, I was in Paris for about 7 years and decided to move back home to New York, where I'm originally from, and kind of build a bridge between Web 2 and Web 3 and bring luxury fashion into the Web 3 space. So our mission, our goal is to be the first luxury brand born from Web3 with the community as our backbone, with different artists, different collaborations as kind of our anchor, right? And our goal and our vision is really to build luxury fashion in a phidgetal way. So your title, ooh, right, is Fashion and Phygitals, and we are all about phygitals because we produce extremely high-end 3D animated NFTs, and the matching NFT twin is a made in Italy luxury fashion piece. So I can talk about us all night long, but essentially that is kind of our bread and butter, which is phygital luxury products. Our team is built by, you know, fashion executives as myself, entertainment people, and also technology people. So we're trying to merge all elements and bring kind of the most luxurious fashion experience to the Web3 community. So we're super excited and honored to be here. You know, we have our big drop one mint coming up on April 27th. So we're, you know, trying to drive hype and doing a lot of promotions and marketing. And yeah, we're just super excited to be in this space. And again, grateful to have wonderful hosts like yourself bring us up and kind of pitch the brand.
I'm really happy to see, I'm right now in your Twitter account, and I'm looking at every single piece and everything that you just mentioned, and it's really incredible. You're really building this luxury fashion brand for Web3, and I just like very curious about the phygital. So tell me, like for instance, which phygital right now is the latest that you did?
Okay, so let's start with our Genesis drop, which was delivered and minted about 2 months ago. Okay, our first collection was Genesis. That was based on sneakers. Okay, so we did an entire phygital collections of sneakers across four models in the middle of February, and that was our Genesis drop. Now we are currently.
Could we pin all of that here?
Yes. So we have the lovely Shekinah, who obviously introduced us. So Shekinah is our
doing the pen stuff. Yeah, I'm doing the pens.
Yeah, she has all the assets. And I just want to thank Shekinah again for introducing us to Talia.
Bravo!
She's the best. Shekinah is like really
the bridge right now.
Our all-star advisor, and also our all-star Web3 lawyer.
Give it up for
Shekinah! Shekinah's the bomb. Yeah. Shekinah's the bomb, you know? So yeah, Shekinah's going to start pinning things up. If you look up first, you're going to see our Genesis drop.
The sneakers are sick.
Thank you. So that was.
I want those. I want to wear those.
No, like redeemable, right? It's like physical redeemables.
Exactly. So Genesis drop was 2 months ago, and now we are launching our drop one, which is Varsity Jackets. Okay. So if you go up top, Shekinah shortly will pin our Varsity Jacket collection, which is called the Nova Style. Okay. Ooh. We have 1,000 NFTs launching on April 27th across four colorways. And one of the colorways, so we have red, green, black, and also blue. And one of the colorways is very special. The black colorway is actually a Web3 community jacket. Okay.
Ooh.
We did a big collaboration with five communities. Okay. And we are featuring five different community patches on our Nova 4 style. So these amazing communities include, we have Wonder Pals, which is one of our, you know, most favorite Web3 projects out there. We have Robatos. So Pablo at Robatos.
I love Pablo. Great awesome pick.
Oh my God, Pablo is like completely, he's fucking the best. He's so radical.
I love him.
He's got great energy, great style, great taste, hyper creativity, and we love the Robatos project. So they're part of our Varsity squad. We also have the Hearts project. So Aiden's my boy, and he was part of the Genesis collection as well with sneakers. Now we brought him back for round two. He has a patch on our Varsity jacket. And then we have Hoppers. So Shaka Blood is also the founder and creative director of Hoppers. So Hoppers is part of our squad. And last but not least, we also have an awesome influencer part of our team who is Deez. So Deez has been, you know, a big supporter of Colton Rain since day one. He's really kind of, kind of had our back since the Genesis drop, and, you know, personally owns a bunch of our Genesis NFTs. And he is part of our collaboration this round with the Varsity Jacket. So we're super, super excited to be bringing the Web3 community another round of, you know, badass 3D animation NFTs with lots of utilities attached to them. And part of the utility obviously includes a luxury matching twin physical jacket.
Oh my God, George, you are missing the Clonex community. and my beautiful avatar will look perfect in one of those jackets.
Absolutely. And that's our goal, right? Like, actually, in the future, our plan is also to launch our avatars, right? So in the next 3 to 6 months, we're gonna launch our own Colton Rain avatars. And we're also going to launch Culture World. Okay. Culture World is going to be our own metaverse experience. And we're already starting to build that out. And our dream, right? Our dream is to be able to build Culture World out and tied this metaverse experience with different metaverse platforms so that our avatar can travel within the rest of the metaverse universe. And you'll be able to wear each of our drops starting from Genesis, drop one, drop two, drop three, and kind of flex these digital wearables in the future.
Oh my God, I really love this. This is a big map. I love the plan. I love the structure that you guys are presenting and tell us all about your beautiful and incredible plans. I really love those sneakers. They are sick. So where do you see the first step in the metaverse is going to be? Where do you see, or where can, I mean, my avatar can wear the jackets now?
Your avatar,
like if I'm going to the Central Land or like,
okay,
like,
so let's talk about great question.
Or Roblox or
So let's talk about the Central Land first. Okay, so our first step into the metaverse will actually be this Friday. Okay, so we are hosting a massive DJ party. We're partnering up with Exclusible. So they're another fashion platform out there, Exclusible. And we are going to airdrop starting tomorrow an unlimited amount of digital wearables of our Varsity Jacket into each of the communities. So essentially, if you are a collaborator with us on our Varsity Jacket drop, you will be able to claim these Varsity Jackets and be able to wear them in Decentraland, okay, on your avatar starting this Friday. So we have a two-hour party. DJ Tropics is going to be doing a two-hour set, and he's badass. He's one of the top DJs within Web3, so we signed him up. And we just made a big investment into our first step into the metaverse, partnering up with Decentraland, partnering up with Exclusible, and our five community collaborators. So we expect a really big blowout, okay? You can actually claim up to 6 of these wearable jackets, and that'll be step one. So step one is we're entering into Decentraland on Friday as we start building out our own metaverse.
God, congratulations. Seriously, I'm so excited. I'm going to try to do my best and stop by.
You have to.
Yes, definitely. I'll try. Just send us again. So here is it. It's at 5, right?
Yes, it's at 5 p.m. Eastern on Friday, the 22nd. So anybody can attend the party, okay? And if you want a metaverse wearable, you just have to go on our Twitter and claim these wearables on gleam.io. So if you go on our Twitter, or if you go on our collaborators' Twitter as well, you can claim each of their wearables, okay, on gleam.io.
And guess what, Talia?
¿Qué pasó?
Couple of giveaways.
What? I love it. For our people. Tenemos aquí unos giveaways, unos regalitos.
So yeah, let's stay put. Like, just keep watching and reading and stages around. We have giveaways from Cotton Rain, giveaways from the Ethereans. So yeah, we have a lot to give.
We want to spread the love, okay? So we want all your listeners, okay? You have a massive, massive following. So we're really honored to be here. We want all of your listeners to have, you know, first dibs on the Cotton Rain drop. So I know we have, you know, a loud list prepared for you guys. Sean, who's part of our team, is also on as the Cotton Rain speaker. So please coordinate with Sean. You know, whatever you guys need, we're here to provide. It's nothing but love.
And if you can, just tell DJ Tropics that that he's invited for Fridays because he never replied my messages.
So. Personal. Ooh, yeah.
Right. We got you. We got
you. Oh, yeah, Robs. We're going to do now a little translation, okay, of everything that you said, but like very short and brief. A ver, ¿quién quiere? Mi Rox, nada más di acerca de lo de Decentraland para que la gente que está aquí quiera participar. ¿Cuándo es? ¿A qué hora?
Sí. Cotton Rain es como una marca de fashion y entonces están tratando de innovar con los productos físicos que pueden ser redimibles. Entonces, uno de sus eventos más importantes va a pasar este viernes a las 5 de la tarde en Decentraland. Y si quieren tener también para sus avatares los wearables, pues van a poderlos ahí adquirir siguiendo la página de Twitter, la cuenta de Twitter de Cotton Rain.
Okay, and a question. So, because that happens to me in the fashion week over there, right? I went in, and then it was so tough for me to find where the whole fashion area was. You know, that was like a nightmare to find that. So, how the people are gonna go there and find you guys?
There is going to be a link that we're going to announce. It's going to take you literally straight into the party. No nonsense.
Perfect.
No walking around, no exploring.
It was terrible.
You're not the first one to tell me that feedback of people getting lost in Decentraland. So we're going to make sure that you enter straight into the party.
Or send us a butler.
Yes.
We'll send you a call. Andy's going to be your butler.
Andy will be there looking for you.
I'll be looking for you. I'll find you. Don't worry.
Oh, my God. This is going to be so, so exciting. Definitely, I'll be there. You send me the link through DM, and we are going to be there. I'm going to record it, or I'm going to show it here live somehow or in my Instagram, and it's going to be fun, and we're going to have a good time. Anything else you want to add?
I would just say that, look, I guess to take a step back, right? We all know that right now we're part of a race into the metaverse, okay? We know that there's a reason why some of the biggest companies in the world, not only across fashion, but across every sector of, you know, any type of business is so geared up towards entering into the metaverse. And the reason we believe strongly in metaverse is because, you know, obviously in the future, everybody's going to have their alter ego, right? Their alter ego is going to become their avatar, which they can literally express themselves free of any type of prejudice or any type of judgment within a space where they can be free, essentially. So we believe that in the future, our kids and their kids and their kids, right, they will live a big part of their life within the metaverse, okay? Within this universe, in this digital space, in this digital environment, on top of obviously living in the real world. So this is something that we're extremely bullish on. And I think that's why, you know, Web3 has taken off so much in the past year as well, is because with the technology behind Web3, we will be able to enter into this space much quicker than Web2, right? So we're super excited, and we know that, you know, this is really the future. So to be so early in the game right now is thrilling, you know, it's thrilling. We're all architects. I mean, Talia, anybody that's within Web3 space, hosting shows and talking about NFTs, talking about Web3 versus Web2, we're all architects of this space right now, and it's super, super exciting.
And talking about building and becoming your own architect, you mentioned before that probably you're thinking to create your own metaverse. Tell us a little alpha.
Okay, we're working with some very, very talented developers right now. Actually, I have a really big meeting with them next week. We've already started building out our proof of concept. And our goal is to first build our Colton Rain culture world, as we call it, as our own environment. Okay, and once we build out this environment, we're going to give access to our culture pass holders. Okay, so anybody that owns a culture pass from Genesis or Drop One, right? If you own an NFT of ours, then you own a culture pass. Anybody that owns this culture pass will be able to have access. So our idea right now is to airdrop all of our culture pass holders this type of access to our culture world. Okay, so from that point on, we will then try to merge our culture world with first with a strong metaverse partner. So I can't tell you guys yet who we're going to partner up with.
Yes, you can.
We want to partner up with somebody that offers, I would say, a little bit higher poly count. So meaning like higher definition graphics, okay, compared to players such as Decentraland or Sandbox. We just feel like, you know, we want to aim towards a luxury experience so that photorealism plays a bigger part into our experience. We all know that, you know, the metaverse experience right now is still in its infant stage, so it still feels very gamey, right? Like very lo-fi, very gamey, very like retro pixelated, but that's all going to evolve for sure. And as people try to push the envelope, as we are, as Colton Rain is, you know, we want to try to break through barriers and build, let's say, a new environment that is higher definition and higher quality. So step one is build our own environment, give access to this environment to our culture pass holders. Okay. And then step two is merge our culture world with other metaverses. Step three would be to launch our avatar collection. So then the avatar can then enter into our culture world and also enter into different metaverses with all of our digital wearables.
That's so exciting. I just see it like in a PS5 game with those like incredible definition games that you know, my son plays some stuff there. I'm like, whoa, this is like if you're there. And it makes total sense.
And I think that's where it's headed, right? That's where it's headed, and that's where it has to go. So not only will you be able to enter into these environments through your mobile phone, through your desktop, but also through VR, right? So that's something that we're exploring too. And it's just super exciting to be like, you know, trying to build something that we know will be part of the future and try to bring kind of like luxury fashion into the mix.
Oh my God, George, I'm so, so happy for you guys. You're very passionate about your baby, and we can feel it. We can feel that you guys are committed. You guys are into it. You are what you're preaching, and that's really cool. And congrats. We really want to get some little goodies. Seriously, I'm really obsessed with those sneakers, the jacket. I'm really crazy.
We're gonna hook you up. We're gonna hook you up.
Yeah.
Sure. I mean, ¿desde que me levanto la manita?
ya levanté yo mi manita. Everybody here wants the little hand. You see, everybody here is like, we want something.
I mean, George, you can talk about. I mean, I probably forget. You can talk about the shoes. You know, the sneakers being like currently being made right now. You know, in Italy.
Yeah, so. Totally. Let's talk about that. So, if you go up top, we actually have like a sneak peek of my factory visit in Florence. I was there actually last week. So it was my second visit to our factory, which is one of the top five shoe manufacturers in Italy. And the reason why we have access to this factory is obviously because our team is built across fashion executives. So I've actually, you know, worked with some of these factories in the past in my previous jobs. And the same factory is based in Tuscany, okay? And they produce for brands such as Louis Vuitton. They produce for Hermes. They produce for Fendi. They produce for Bottega Veneta.
Oh la la.
Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Really, they're one of the most luxurious sneaker manufacturers and shoe manufacturers within Italy. And we were super honored that literally they took on Colt and Rain as their first startup client in like three generations. Huh? And the reason why the owner took on Colt and Rain is because he liked and believed in our concept. He knew that, you know, he wanted to be part of also Web3, right? He wanted to be part of this metaverse, let's say, I don't want to say gold rush, but like this metaverse experience. So he was very excited about the project, and literally we signed up with them about 3 months ago. And that was like kind of making history, right? Because our units being produced in their factory is like peanuts, you know, compared to the big brands. But, you know, you don't have to be the biggest brand in the world as well sometimes. As long as you come up with a clever concept, you know, I think, you know, a lot of people out there will respect you. So we're really honored also to be part of like Italian manufacturing to support, you know, all the artisans behind the factories that have worked there for generations. And if you look at the clip above, you'll
I don't see the clip. Where is the clip?
It's the first one. Okay.
The first one.
Yes. So you'll see that all of the molds that we created from the shoes are original. So we invested 250,000 euros just in producing the four molds. So that was a massive, massive to bring original designs into Web3. Okay. We did not put our design on an existing block, which believe me would have been much, much cheaper. But because
And easy, exactly.
But because
the little voice in the background.
Exactly. Everybody tells me every day on my team, oh my God, why are we spending so much on costs? And I say to them, we're spending so much because we're investing. We're investing in the brand and we want to make a name for ourselves. And the only way to do that is to build the most luxurious product for this space. And if we can be known within Web3 as the brand that brings ultra luxury physical redeemables attached with NFTs, you know, then we'll be happy.
Because, but accessible, right? Of course. Not as difficult to get or so expensive that it's like impossible. You want to try to do that in an accessible way. VIP, but accessible way, right?
Absolutely. I mean, I think Web3 is free for all, you know, and, you know, with the allowless format, right? Anybody has a shot to have access to our NFTs. So, you know, we're giving out a lot of allow lists to different goodies. We're running different contests and we just want to spread the love, you know? So as we scale up, you know, we're going to have more offerings, of course, but at this moment, we still want to keep our collection scarce. Okay. So that it becomes, you know, it becomes special, right? So that's really important to us, that we give value through all the utilities attached to the Culture Pass. So we have many different utilities attached, and part of the utility is the physical twin. So yeah, we're just super thrilled, super excited. You know, you can probably tell I'm super passionate about Colt and Rain. The team is too. And we just feel like we're kind of, you know, building something new, a new model, something that's different than what Web2 fashion brands can offer. And I think kind of like, you know, sky's the limit in the future.
Glamorous, expensive, beautiful, quality, everything that is yummy, 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 yummy. Congratulations, guys. Seriously, this is delish. It's just like so amazing what you're doing.
Talia, where are you from? Like, where are you based?
I'm from Mexico. I'm from Mexico.
Where in Mexico?
Living in New York, but in the jungle.
Where in Mexico? Santa Maria la Ribera.
Oh my God.
Welcome to the jungle.
Come visit us. Let's come visit you.
Got it. Okay. Where are you based?
We're in New York.
Oh my God, stop it. No. Okay, good. Next week, we'll be there.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Oh my God.
We're gonna go nuts. Okay, good. DM me and that's it. The end of the world.
Let's do this. Let's
go. Oh my God, I'm excited.
We'll be the host. This is our home court. New York City. Andy and I are here. and we're going to show you around the town.
Yeah, isn't it amazing that the community, the crypto, the Web3 community is based like in New York? And isn't it amazing how it's moving here now?
It's all over the world. I mean,
or it was always here.
All over the world. But yeah, exactly. Now it's like a lot of people in this space in New York. That's what I see.
Yeah.
¿Qué pasó en mi talla, no? Los zapatos.
Total.
Sí, la mía también, pero me deja, I'm going to raise my hand for the size of the shoe.
Everybody is going to DM me like shoe size and everything. All right, guys, thank you. This was fantastic. We're going to roll the mic, okay?
Let's roll the mic. Let's keep going.
All right, Rox, ¿a quién tenemos?
Ahora tenemos a los de Style Exchange. They are based in Berlin, so probably it's like 2 a.m. or 1 a.m. or something around there. And so let them talk. It's Leo.
Hola,
one of the founders and someone that is speaking now.
Hola. Hello.
Mil gracias por este espacio.
No, hombre, gracias a ti por estar aquí, por conectarte. Entonces, ¿dónde estás?
Andamos aquí en Berlín.
Wow. ¿Y viven allá o qué?
Sí, aquí vivimos.
Espectacular. Y me encanta, o sea, que de pronto me mandaste algunos DMs y estaban en español y yo así como, sí. Que, ¡ay, qué rico, qué delicia! Es que
yo soy la marketing manager de aquí y soy de México, pero ahora vivo aquí en Berlín, entonces era más fácil en español.
Muy bien, perfecto. Entonces vamos a hacer en español y en inglés para que todos estén aquí. Sí. Es un rollo inclusivo para todo el mundo. Pero
mejor en inglés. Porque conmigo está Leo Gilse. He's the CEO of Style Exchange. And his Spanish could use some work. So it's better in English.
Okay, good. Hi, Leo. Welcome.
Hey, guys. I hope you can hear me.
Yes, perfectly.
All right, cool. Well, thank you for inviting us, and yes, Bettina, also for setting it up. I will continue in English, though, however, because my Spanish is not that fresh anymore.
Don't worry, my English is like your Spanish, so don't worry, we're even. So, Leo, tell me, so what time is it there?
It's like 1:30 in the morning.
Woohoo! Party time!
Yeah, it's a good time for
yes.
Flex voice.
Party time.
Yeah, sure.
Exactly, I love
Monday.
That.
Well, party time Monday. All the time in Berlin.
I love that. Tell us about your company. Tell us about everything, your project.
Sure, yeah. So Style Exchange is basically a virtual fashion NFT marketplace featuring brands or individual creators, designers from across the globe. We've been around for a couple of weeks now. Ever since the beginning of January, we featured, I think, 20 plus designers by now from around the globe, from New York to Korea. We've had a Mexican designer as well. And what we kind of try to do is really focus on the utility of the fashion NFTs. So as with any other platform, you can purchase the fashion NFTs, you know, in Ethereum or Fiat and then have them on your wallet. But we actually go one step further and make sure that every individual asset is bridged into the metaverse. So currently we have everything running on Decentraland, where whenever you get a piece, you automatically get the metaverse copy for Decentraland. At the moment, we're integrating Sandbox as well, which probably should be done until the end of the month. So then automatically every piece would be available for the Sandbox avatar. Additionally, and then in the future, the goal is to get more and more metaverses on board to kind of like provide a launch pad platform for designers and brands to bridge assets to that are applicable in the multiverse.
That's so cool. So you're already that platform, that marketplace, right? So then you you can get your looks in the central land, like you can use them in the central land soon in Sandbox. This is so unique and so exciting. I mean, the sky is the limit. What else you're planning for you guys?
Well, I think for the Style Exchange platform as is, that's pretty much it. It's a launch pad, as I said, and we want to feature more designers and creators. But what's really exciting is actually what we're building in the background, because Style Exchange is running on Style Protocol, which is essentially the ecosystem powering this NFT interoperability. And this is something that I'm super, super excited about, because it actually once completely developed, so we're obviously still in development as all other ventures in the space, but once completely developed, it will open up the opportunity for more NFT bridging other than simply fashion. So we will be able to, you know, as I said, make the fashion NFTs utilizable across different metaverses. And by the way, when I say utilizable across different metaverses, I mean that you can also have one asset in the Decentraland and then have the same asset applicable in the other metaverses automatically just by, you know, owning the original NFT. But this also works for any other asset. So it can be virtual fashion, as I said, but it can also be, let's say, Bored Ape or, I don't know, some Tamagotchi, or it can be a pet, it can be a virtual car. So whatever kind of like NFT collection is out there, let's say Fancy Bears or CryptoPunks, or I don't know, some new swans or whatever, you know, through the protocol, we can virtualize these characters, skins, avatars, and assets and make them inter-metaverse operable. And I think this is something that's really cool because in the future, you know, if somebody has an NFT that they're really excited about, potentially they want to like utilize this on their skin and not just in one metaverse, but in multiple.
Oh, that's so cool. Like, I'm so totally in love, completely obsessed with my profile picture, my Clonex. I love that little guy. So this is very exciting for me.
Yeah, then exactly this would be the idea. So, I mean, just as I'm sorry, I forgot your name, but the Culture and Rain speaker from earlier mentioned that they're building, you know, their own metaverse where they can have the high...
Hello, hello.
Come again?
I said hello, hello.
Hello, hello. What's your name, dude?
I'm George.
George. All right, cool, George.
Leo.
Yeah. Mine is a little bit more visible in the profile.
It's 2 a.m. It's 2 a.m. over there.
You got to open a drink, man. This party started. I think I'm going to pour myself a scotch. Oh, you got to be fired up.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So, Leo, but this is like, for instance, like if I have, if I get one of your pieces, right? And then if I open my camera and if I take a picture of me, it could take a picture of me with the outfit that I just bought?
Yeah, I mean, so we don't have like instant AR filters for like I don't know, Instagram or Snapchat. We try to focus solemnly on the assets for the virtual worlds, like the different metaverses where you can then walk around and run around. But we do have something that is what we call a 2D fitting. So if you purchase a fashion NFT and you share a picture with us, then you get like a high quality fit fashion NFT on your picture that you can then reshare on social media. But to be honest, this is something that we kind of added as a, you know, nice to have feature so that people can have it in 2D and can, you know, showcase it and flex it on Instagram. But I think what's really exciting and, you know, what most of the people in this space are going to be bullish about is the actual utilities in the 3D worlds and then, you know, being able to immerse yourself in like new virtual avatars according to your like crazy imagination.
It's really cool. Like I'm looking at all the outfits and everything that you guys are creating. It's really so unique and so exciting. I mean, the sky is the limit. What else you're planning for you guys?
Well, I think for the Style Exchange platform as is, that's pretty much it. It's a launch pad, as I said, and we want to feature more designers and creators. But what's really exciting is actually what we're building in the background, because Style Exchange is running on Style Protocol, which is essentially the ecosystem powering this NFT interoperability. And this is something that I'm super, super excited about because it actually, once completely developed, so we're obviously still in development as all other ventures in the space, but once completely developed, it will open up the opportunity for more NFT bridging other than simply fashion. So we will be able to, you know, as I said, make the fashion NFTs utilizable across different metaverses. And by the way, when I say utilizable across different metaverses, I mean that you can also have one asset in the Decentraland and then have the same asset applicable in the other metaverses automatically just by, you know, owning the original NFT. But this also works for any other asset. So it can be virtual fashion, as I said, but it can also be, let's say, Bored Ape or, I don't know, some Tamagotchi, or it can be a pet, it can be a virtual car. So whatever kind of like NFT collection is out there, let's say Fancy Bears or CryptoPunks, or I don't know, some new swans or whatever, you know, through the protocol, we can virtualize these characters, skins, avatars, and assets and make them inter-metaverse operable. And I think this is something that's really cool because in the future, you know, if somebody has an NFT that they're really excited about, potentially they want to, like, utilize this on their skin and not just in one metaverse, but in multiple.
Oh, that's so cool. Like, I'm so totally in love, completely obsessed with my profile picture, my Clonex. I love that little guy. So this is very exciting for me.
Yeah, then exactly this would be the idea. So, I mean, just as, I'm sorry, I forgot your name, but the Culture and Rain speaker from earlier mentioned that they're building, you know, their own metaverse where they can have the high...
Hello, hello.
Come again?
I said hello, hello.
Hello, hello. What's your name, dude?
I'm George.
George. All right, cool, George.
Leo.
Yeah. Mine is a little bit more visible in the profile.
It's 2 a.m. It's 2 a.m. over there.
You gotta open a drink, man. This party started. I think I'm gonna pour myself a scotch. Talia got me fired up.
Oh yeah. Okay. So Leo, but this is like, for instance, like if I have if I get one of your pieces, right? And then if I open my camera and if I take a picture of me, it could take a picture of me with the outfit that I just bought.
Yeah, I mean, so we don't have like instant AR filters for like I don't know, Instagram or Snapchat. We try to focus solemnly on the assets for the virtual worlds, like the different metaverses where you can then walk around and run around. But we do have something that is what we call a 2D fitting. So if you purchase a fashion NFT and you share a picture with us, then you get like a high quality fit fashion NFT on your picture that you can then reshare on social media. But to be honest, this is something that we kind of added as a, you know, nice to have feature so that people can have it in 2D and can, you know, showcase it and flex it on Instagram. But I think what's really exciting and, you know, what most of the people in this space are going to be bullish about is the actual utilities in the 3D worlds and then, you know, being able to immerse yourself in like new virtual avatars according to your like crazy imagination.
It's really cool. Like I'm looking at all the outfits and everything that you guys are creating. It's really like it's futuristic, it's fun, it's colorful. I see like kimonos and skirts and mermaid tails and wings. It's really cool. So you're planning to do any other platform, any other game?
Yeah. So well, maybe it's a good thing to mention that we're completely open to, you know, any like designers or collaborators that are interested to drop fashion with us. If there's anyone in this space interested to getting their collection out there,
let's and talk. Also
having it, you know, applicable. Come again, George.
I said, let's talk, Leo.
For sure. Yeah, sounds exciting. Absolutely. And yeah, in addition to the Style Exchange platform, we're currently in development of what we call Meta Freaks. It's a platform that we're going to be probably finalizing development by the end of the month, and then we're dropping this as well. It's a completely new thing. It's another platform where we will focus on skins and avatars, and it's running on the same protocol that I've mentioned earlier, the Style protocol. So there we will be focusing on kind of like crazy fantasy beings. So I don't know, zombies, orcs, mummies, you know, from the ancient Egypt, and all these kinds of like gamified characters that are then going to be NFTs that are also applicable across the different metaverses that we collaborate with.
It's really cool. So you know what, George, Leo, what happens in these spaces and that we've been like watching lately is like we're basically that bridge where everybody comes and they collide. They DM themselves and everybody start working and collabing together. So this that you just said, like George, you said, Leo, call me. I mean, I think that's fantastic. And that's exactly the purpose of these spaces.
Exactly. And that's the beauty of Web3, right? Like, we're all in it together, and if one of us wins, we all win at the end. And that
100%, 100%.
That goes with the community too, and that's that power that you can feel within Web3 that's different than Web2, and that's why we joined this revolution. Really, it's a revolution, because if anybody within Web3 wins, we all win together. We all gain from it. And that's beautiful.
Yeah. Additionally, what I think is so exciting is that it's very individual and like creator focused, and especially since we're like super super early in the space, it's a fantastic time for individuals to kind of like start something, and the creator community, or like the creator economy as they say, is much more enabled in this space than they were ever before, because it's a lot more easy for individuals to just go out there and start something and have their things seen.
And we also have to consider the contribution of digital fashion to the environment, right? It's like it's something that sometimes is not mentioned, that I think has to be mentioned, because it's a lot of pollution that come from the fashion industry as we know it, and now the digital fashion is like solving that issue, right?
I think so. I mean, it's I don't think it's going to solve the entire fashion industry's issue with, you know, being unsustainable, because there's always, you know, as we live on a planet, as a species, we'll always have the need for wearing clothing. And I'm personally a huge fan of physical fashion still. And I mean, there's cool stuff out there that you want to showcase. But I think the digital aspect definitely, or I hope that in the future, it will reduce the kind of like mass consumption of fashion that we have right now, and the focus will go more towards individual, sustainable, long-lasting pieces such as George's, for example, doing with Culture and Rain. We have, like, you know, high quality wear that is lasting longer than what we see right now with Primark and all.
And absolutely, that's one of the reasons why I left Web2 to join Web3, is the fact that you know at my last job at Charuti, I was designing 10 collections per year, including two runway shows, right, per year. So if you think about 10 collections and 10 deliveries, it's way too much.
We
don't need any more clothes on top of clothes,
no.
Racks on top of racks, fast fashion on top of fast fashion. And sustainability is definitely something that we thought about, right? Like think about this. We are now producing NFTs tied with physical products, but these are all made to order, okay? Made to order. You know what the biggest problem with the fashion industry is? And I can tell you right now, because I was part of it for 18 years, is stock. What happens when the clothes don't sell? Do you guys think about that, though? Like, when you go into Uniqlo, for example, you go into Zara. I mean, how much clothes are there within one store? Think about it. And that's multiplied by like 2,000 stores. What happens to the clothes when they don't sell? Everything gets marked down. Everything gets filtered into outlets. And then afterwards, where does it go? It goes into landmines, huh? I mean, it goes into our world. It goes into the soil. It goes into, you know, it goes on Earth, basically. And that is something that we want to reverse. So if you look at our model with Colton Ray, we're producing made-to-order things, right? When you buy an NFT, when you buy our collection, we know exactly how many numbers. We have no waste. We have no stock. We're producing it as it goes. You come onto our website, you claim the size. If you buy 10, you claim 10 sizes. And we'll ship it to you for free.
Mm-hmm.
Worldwide shipping. So we spoke about, you know, being global earlier, right? We spoke about Web3 as being super international and super global. What I can tell you this, from our Genesis collection, we had collectors, and we call each of our buyers a collector. We don't call them customers, we call them collectors, okay? We had collectors across 42 different countries. 42 different countries. Can you imagine?
Wow.
A startup fashion brand like Colton Rain, our first collection being sold into 42 different countries. And I think that is a beautiful thing, right? To become international from day one. Yes, the numbers are small right now, but this is a stepping stone. This is a foundation that we're building off of, right? Every major company started like this, from a garage, from a first collection, and they built up.
It's really exciting. It's really like invigorating to hear you guys talking about this. I have to ask, why Colton Rain? I like the name so much. I want to know why.
Okay, good question. So Colton Rain actually started from paper and pencil. And the first thing I drew on paper was hashtag C-U-L-T-R, which is culture, right? Culture, short for culture, is C-U-L-T-R. And cult is an assembly of people that believe in something, right? Believe in a goal, believe in something. Mm-hmm. Our idea is to make culture reign around the world. So that's why.
Ooh, I love it.
And we have drop models, right? Like we start with Genesis. Now we're doing drop one, drop two, drop three. And we want our drops to drop around the world. And that's why we came up with Colton Rain.
Perfect name. Now I like it even more. Bravo.
Make a rain, right? Talia, we're going to make a rain. Are we going to make a rain in New York next week?
Totally, we're going to. Okay, but now before you guys like go, tell me about what is your fashion style? And I want to start with Leo, your personal fashion style.
My personal... but I think my personal fashion style is super... I don't know, mid-20s founder. I mean, ask Bettina. I usually just wear jeans and a sweater or like a hoodie to the office.
Bettina, dime. Bettina.
No, I think he's very casual and like chill in the way.
She said it all. He's very casual.
He is very casual, but I think he likes to wear a lot of like nice colors, which is good, but like always with a hoodie or a hat. Very mid-20s appropriate.
Oh, I like that. I like that. I mean, what is yours, Bettina?
Mine? Uh-huh.
More fashionable. You're always dressed up in the office. You look nice.
Well, I mean, Talia can back me up with this because in Mexico, everyone dresses up way more. I mean, in Berlin, it's not like this. So,
yeah, Berlin people are slums. That's true.
Yeah. So... I do try to dress up also because I studied fashion design, so I need to live up to that. But I think my style is also a little bit like sober and classic, I would say.
Ooh, I like that.
Yeah.
Cool. George, what is yours?
So I would say...
And don't lie to me because I'm going to meet you in person.
I'm not lying to you. You'll see the style soon. I'm more like rocking like 80s inspired type of mood.
Ooh.
Everything oversized. I'm mixing like, you know, sportswear with like oversized, you know, jackets. I'm bringing back a lot of like retro sneakers because I'm a sneakerhead, right? So that's how the company started. Was because, you know, I'm a sneakerhead. I collect a lot of sneakers. So
like which one? Which is your favorite?
Oh my God. They're like
from your collection.
They're all my babies, you know? So I would say like lately, like I've been, you know, sporting a lot of Sakai Nikes, right? So that's kind of part of the repertoire right now. I also rock like retro, obviously Jordans, you know, like I have my black ones that I wear. Almost every day.
How about a leotard? How about a leotard and some warmers?
Oh my God.
How about that? In fact, I was watching Despicable Me 3 yesterday, and my favorite villain is that guy that dances. And he's like the one that steals the purple diamond, and his style is amazing.
Oh my God, that's hilarious. Yeah, I'm not rocking any leotards.
Yeah, a little leotard, a purple leotard.
I might go with the
or a head warmer.
Yeah. Head warmers. Yeah, that's cool. Okay. So yeah, that's what I wear. A lot of like, you know, 80s wash jeans right now, leather jackets mixed with like retro sneakers.
Oh, we're talking about retro sneakers. Did you see those Back to the Future ones they put out for a couple of years ago? Did you see those?
Yeah, the Nike ones.
I love those. Yeah. I love those.
We're, you know, I think the retro style is never going to go out of style, right? Every, like, as a fashion designer, you're always referencing different time periods, right? So right now we're in the 90s moment, right? So 90s is being referenced a lot. Before it was the 80s. Right, before it was the 70s, so it's kind of
it goes around. Yeah, all the time.
It's like a recycling pot that goes around,
and it gets mixed. It's like
exactly,
music.
And then you cut it, you mix it, right? You can mix it with, you know, minimalism. You can mix it with, you know, streetwear, And I think that's the beauty of fashion, is that it is art, it is creativity. And at the end, you can, you know, do whatever you want. And that's style, right? Style is something that just makes you feel good at the end of the day. So that's why I always enjoyed being a fashion designer, because you're like producing things that make people feel good at the end.
Bravo, me encantan los proyectos. ¿Quieres, ¿quieres traducir un poquito?
Pues mira, yo creo que Bettina puede hablar un poquito de Style Exchange en español para que diga sí. lo que no se escuchó en español.
En cortito, Bettina, please.
Sí, claro, con gusto. Somos una plataforma de moda de NFTs y lo que nosotros estamos haciendo es que nosotros pasamos la moda, creamos los diseños en 3D y los pasamos al metaverso. Entonces tú cuando compras un NFT con nosotros, lo puedes usar tanto en 2D, o sea, nos puedes mandar una foto y nosotros te lo ponemos con alta calidad en tu foto para que lo puedas compartir, o lo puedes usar en el metaverso. Ahorita estamos con con Decentraland y con Sandbox, y ya próximamente serán más.
Súper, me encanta. De verdad que qué emoción todo, escuchar todo lo que está pasando con la moda en este mundo fantástico, pero sobre todo que no solamente se queda en un NFT, sino que están viendo la forma de que también sea una pieza que al mismo tiempo te llegue, que llegue a tus manos y que sea algo exclusivo ligado a tu NFT. Espectacular todo
esto.
Sí,
claro. Hoy en día es impresionante todo lo que se puede hacer. O sea, en verdad es... Ya el futuro está aquí, literal.
Increíble, increíble. ¿Qué colaboraciones tienen con algunos artistas, con algunas marcas? ¿Tienen algo así planeado?
Pues todavía lo estamos viendo, pero lo que sí tenemos es colaboraciones con diseñadores un poco más pequeños, porque también al final es algo nuevo y hay mucha competencia entre todos, aunque todos nos ayudamos también, todos ofrecemos algo diferente y todos tenemos un estilo diferente. Entonces, sí intentamos buscar diseñadores que sean más pequeños y no tan reconocidos para poder hacer este tipo de colaboraciones y también sacar su nombre, ¿no? Para que también ellos puedan ayudarnos mutuamente. Y también tenemos diseñadores in-house que son los que ellos nos diseñan a nosotros, en nuestro nombre. Y, por ejemplo, ahorita nuestro último diseño que va a salir esta semana, nuestra última colección, que se llama Down the Rabbit Hole, que es inspirada por las Pascuas. Tenemos algunos diseños de pequeños diseñadores, más aparte diseñadores de nosotros.
Y eso son esa colección que se abre como que el huevo, ¿no?
Sí, sí, justo. Se rompe el huevo para...
Y sale algo sorpresa, ¿no? Algo que sí. Nadie sabe que le va a tocar.
Exacto, exacto. Sí, eso...
You get a surprise.
Sí, tuvimos justo el evento ayer en Decentraland. Estuvo padrísimo.
Ay, gracias por invitar, ¿eh? Thank you for inviting.
Ay, estaba ahí. Para la próxima te lo voy a mandar el link así directo.
Oye, Bettina, y por ejemplo, si así artistas latinoamericanos que hagan o que estén involucrados en fashion, ¿pueden aplicar o cómo le hacen con ustedes?
Sí, claro. Siempre estamos abiertos a nuevas colaboraciones y a conocer a nuevas personas. Ahorita más que nada estamos viéndolo a través de Discord, pero también con todo el gusto nos pueden escribir directo por Twitter. Yo aquí estoy para contestarles a todos.
¿Sabes? Yo creo que una de las maneras que también podrían ver así ahorita lo que salió con Colton Ray, la colaboración podría ser también con, por ejemplo, Pedro de The Fabricant, que es una plataforma en donde hay personas que pueden entrar a la plataforma y co-crear con otros diseñadores. Pues ellos producen sus piezas, ¿no? Entonces, si pueden armar colaboración y ustedes también formar parte de los marketplaces en donde se comercializan las piezas de The Fabricant o de otros que producen digital fashion, estaría padrísimo.
Sí, claro, eso estaría increíble.
También dilo en inglés para que George lo entienda.
¿Qué cosa?
It's okay.
Okay, good.
A little bit, don't worry.
All right, perfect.
Ay, muy bien.
So, Pedro, hi, how are you?
Hola Talia, hola Rox, hola a todos, hola Alan, hi Talia, hi everyone here in the room tonight. I'm a Mexican guy. I am a community manager here at The Fabricant, which is the first digital fashion house que vendió. Lo voy a decir en español para toda la comunidad latina que está aquí, porque veo muchas caras conocidas, igual Talía, por invitarte y darte a conocer este proyecto que es muy, 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 muy bueno. Y te saludo desde Ámsterdam con todo el equipo de The Fabrican. Nos trajeron aquí. Es la primer casa mundial que vendió el primer NFT de moda a nivel mundial. Esa es la importancia de esta compañía. En el 2018 se vendió el primer vestido digital como NFT. Y esta empresa es fundada por Kerry, por Adriana y por Amber. Amber fue estudiante de moda digital y fue la primera persona a nivel mundial en crear una colección como su proyecto de tesis de únicamente moda digital.
Wow, so you guys were the first one.
Exactly, The Fabrican is the very first digital
fashion
house. Yes, and we have made a lot of collaborations with many artists from all over the world. Now we have the Fabrican Studio, which is this platform in which you can co-create with many other designers and also material designers, two NFTs for free. And we're about to launch the next edition, which is the Fabrican Studio Season 2, in which you can have the opportunity to co-create up to 5 NFTs for free. And it's all inspired by the Shiny Zodiac signs. And it's a collaboration that we are doing with the Chinese artist Steffi Funk. But the thing that I would love to point out is that, yeah, digital fashion is important, not only in a creative way or in creative as a self-expression way, as a way just to express yourself, but also to all the things that, for example, if you're a fashion designer, you don't have to go and to buy the materials, all of those materials, and also those things that you cannot use in the physical, in the digital realm are there. You can use like gold to create a t-shirt or a dress. You can use the stars instead of any other fabric, let's say. So yeah, we are the Fabrican. We are very happy to collaborate with all of us, with all of you. And we have also a Discord, a community, and we host more than 7,000 people now from all over the world. And yeah, we have also this community in Spanish, la comunidad en español, que aquí
Bravo,
veo,
la comunidad aquí presente.
Aquí estamos Beta, que está aquí como auditor, Antonio, que también han colaborado y hace poco se hizo el Metaverse Fashion Week en el Centraland, que es uno de los metaversos más importantes. Y en The Fabrican, Enrique y yo, que somos los mexicanos, que estamos en esta empresa internacional holandesa, pues le damos mucha importancia a esta comunidad hispanohablante de todo el mundo, porque también estos temas y esos conceptos como metaverso y NFTs son importantísimos de escucharlos también en la lengua madre, para poder no únicamente comprenderlos, pero los podemos comprender en cualquier idioma, sino para poder tener esta retroalimentación y también difundir con más personas. De eso se trata todo esto, la democratización y llegar a muchísimas más personas siempre, porque únicamente colaborando es que se puede crear esta Web3.
Pero Pedro, espectacular lo que acabas de decir, porque yo estoy segura que en este espacio hay diseñadores también que no saben cómo llegar pues a Web3, cuáles son los primeros pasos, cómo aterrizar sus bocetos, sus ideas, que seguramente hay gente muy, muy talentosa aquí en el espacio, o si no saben de otra persona muy talentosa, que yo siempre digo, por favor, síganse los unos a los otros, mándense DMs y hagan esos lazos de conexión, porque de eso se trata, de ayudarse uno al otro. Y qué increíble, ¿qué puedes decir a estas personas que nos están escuchando y que de pronto dicen, híjole, yo sí quiero trabajar, o cómo puedo hacer para llegar ahí, y cómo puedo hacer para mandar mis diseños?
Bueno, la recomendación que siempre he dado desde que estaba estudiando es, pues si saben inglés, pueden llegar a muchas más personas, y utilícenlo como herramienta. La verdad es de que a nivel mundial hay que ver así el inglés como una herramienta para llegar a más personas, tanto como esta plática y todos los demás conceptos. Todo lo que llega día a día, las noticias más recientes, los NFTs y cualquier otro tema que les guste, ya sea ciencia, sea arte, sea sociales, siempre la información más reciente va a ser inglés. Y eso no tiene que ser una limitante, al contrario, tiene que ser algo que ustedes puedan utilizar para poder comunicarse y conectar con más personas. Y de ahí, pues la pasión que ustedes tengan. Un NFT, pues podemos hablar de NFTs como algo de arte, hoy, esta noche hablando de moda, pero un NFT al final del día puede ser cualquier, pues, token, ¿no? Fungible, ¿no? Entonces, pues yo creo que la recomendación es ser fieles a ustedes mismos, cómo poder adaptar la Web3, esta nueva, que ustedes pueden crear con ella también lo que ustedes quieran.
Oye, y recientemente sacaron un artículo en Vogue de que ustedes también recibieron unas inversiones maravillosas para seguir con el proyecto, ¿no?
Sí, estamos muy contentos porque, pues muchas veces, el hablar de moda digital o de estas cosas digitales, y digo cosas porque así lo pueden decir muchas personas, puede sonar como no tan tangible y puede ser un poquito complejo de entender de un cotidiano 2020 para atrás. Pero pues sí, en The Fabricant hemos recibido una inversión de 14 millones para poder seguir construyendo y dando muchos trabajos, incluido el mío, y también conectando con muchas otras personas para poder seguir pues esta realidad de poder crear todo el guardarropa de todos los avatars del metaverso. Y no únicamente es de nosotros, de que lo queremos apropiar, pues no, todas las personas, todos los co-creadores y co-creadoras que están aquí en esta plática esta noche, que han sido parte de la plataforma de The Fabricant, bien van a saber y no me van a dejar mentir que pues todo es gratis. Ustedes pueden entrar, co-crearlo, pueden vender dentro del marketplace que existe de The Fabricant. Esto es algo pues colaborativo. Sí, esta inversión fue más bien para poder seguir este proyecto, ¿no? Como cualquier otro proyecto, como un sponsor. Pero pues lo más importante de la moda digital, la capacidad de creación. Y no únicamente tienen que ser una empresa hiper reconocida para poder vender un NFT o crear un bien de moda digital. Eso es lo bueno de la moda digital. Nosotros en The Fabricant tenemos el aquel de que puede ser un estudiante de París, como puede serlo de la India, de México, de Canadá, de Australia. Y no es de que uno sea más menos que otro, es que todos tenemos ahora la oportunidad de realmente una democratización creativa. Podemos vender el mismo NFT en la misma plataforma y pues tener ese bien como negocio y bien creativo. La creatividad es el límite aquí.
Oye, Pedro, entonces, o sea, tú puedes meterte, o sea, una persona que esté aquí puede meterse a la plataforma y puedes empezar a, ¿qué es? ¿Codiseñas? O sea, ¿diseñas junto con ustedes? ¿Cómo funciona ese aspecto de diseñar la pieza junto con ustedes?
Sí, de hecho, ahorita tenemos ya la colección de Studio 2, donde uno entra a thefabricant.studio, S-T-U-D-I-O.
Pinéalo aquí.
Ya, ¿okay? Ya está pineado.
Ok.
Gracias. Y ahí pueden únicamente conectan su wallet de Blockto. Igual nosotros no tenemos que ver ahí con la Blockto wallet. Nunca entramos a sus passwords, nunca les pedimos nada. Únicamente conectan y pueden comenzar a co-crear. El co-crear significa que tenemos un diseñador o varios diseñadores o diseñadoras en colaboración con determinada temporada. Ahorita es la temporada 2 y tenemos dos colaboraciones. Tenemos la de Steffi Fong y también tenemos con World of Women.
Oh my God, esa me excita porque, o sea, yo tengo mi World of Women y vi la fotito que subieron con los diseños. Yo estoy así como flipeadísima.
Es un gran colectivo, muy necesario también, y yo creo que esa también es otro tema para otra plática, porque también la intervención social a través de los NFTs y los medios digitales es importantísima. Yo creo que algo cuando una persona tiene una intención, pues todo sale bien, y World of Women, la intención que tienen y la misión y la visión, pues es demasiado poderosa.
Sí.
Y retomando un poquito lo de Studio 2, pues tenemos estas dos colaboraciones en las que los participantes pueden co-crear, pueden utilizar, seleccionar materiales de otros creadores y otras creadoras, digamos que son los textiles con los que pueden jugar con varias combinaciones. Pueden seleccionar también un garment que ya está como prehecho para ese personalizarlo. Y al final, ese NFT tiene estos tres créditos. Tiene el crédito del co-creador o la co-creadora, del quién fue la diseñadora o el diseñador de ese tipo de material y quién fue la diseñadora o diseñador de ese garment. Entonces, pues ahí está la democratización otra vez y se puede vender también en un marketplace que se rige bajo Flow. Y sí, la verdad es que, pues, yo creo que todos los que estamos en el ambiente de moda digital, y no me van a dejar aquí mentir, todos los que estamos como hablantes y escuchantes, pues es muy distinto a la moda convencional, un poco ya antigua, en el sentido de que pues toda la información está allá afuera. Si uno quiere aprender, únicamente es tener las ganas, y en YouTube están todos los tutoriales. En The Fabricant tenemos también un canal de YouTube donde está antes de Cloth 3D, para que puedan las personas, pues más que aprender, enseñarse a sí mismas cómo utilizar este software, cómo crear chamarras, cómo utilizar las herramientas básicas. Hemos tenido también hangouts en muchos metaversos, tutoriales para crear sus avatars. Toda la información está allá afuera. Yo personalmente me encargo de la comunidad en español, pero pues aquí como Antonio, aquí como, pues como muchos que veo aquí que son parte de esta comunidad, son los que crean también esta comunidad y crean ese contenido que es tan importante.
¡Shout out for Antonio!
Sí, 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 arriba Toñito, que además sí. Siempre está apoyando.
Sí, 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 sí.
Y bueno, tenemos a Isa, que creo quiere hacer una pregunta, entonces pues le damos la palabra a alguien del público, a ver si hay alguna pregunta.
Bueno, Isa es estudiante. A ver, les voy a dar una introducción de Isa, porque ella es parte de la comunidad de Fabricant y ella es estudiante de moda en CEDIM, en Monterrey. Y pues para mí, los estudiantes son el futuro en muchos ámbitos. Y yo creo que la voz de Isa ha sido demasiado poderosa en la comunidad, en el sentido de la representación de las inquietudes que pueden tener varias personas como estudiantes, y también la responsabilidad que podemos tener otras personas en cuestión de compartir y difundir cierto tipo de información.
Isa, ¿cómo estás? Bienvenida.
Hola, Talía, mucho gusto. Wow, esto es muy surreal.
Encantada, bienvenida, cuéntanos.
Pues, no sé, o sea, las dudas que me han surgido a lo largo de este camino del metaverso. Y bueno, se agradece mucho a toda la comunidad, siempre ha sido muy abierta y muy amable, y es algo muy importante a tomar en cuenta. Pues, no sé, o sea, por ejemplo, para las chicas de Style, ¿qué dificultades se han encontrado? No sé si, porque me tuve que ir un momentito, hoy vengo, pero ¿qué dificultades se han encontrado pues a la hora de generar comunidad en la parte latinoamericana? O sea, ¿por qué México, bueno, Latinoamérica hablando, o sea, ¿qué le hace falta? ¿Para qué, qué impulso hace falta para que exista ese boom? No sé si me lo quiero responder.
¿Cómo vincular con la comunidad latinoamericana, Betina?
Pues yo, la verdad, esto es algo, es mi opinión personal, pero yo creo que más bien es algo tan nuevo que no siento que haya llegado todavía a Latinoamérica. Entonces sí falta como un poco más de información y un poco más de, o sea, yo creo que justo gracias a Talía y a Rox esto se está volviendo un poquito más famoso, estamos ayudando a las personas a que tengan este interés y esta curiosidad de saber sobre todo esta cosa, esto nuevo, porque al final es algo que se va a quedar aquí, o sea, llegó para quedarse. Entonces, creo que tiene que ser poco a poco, y gracias a este tipo de espacios es como se va a crear más curiosidad y más gente va a querer estar metida en esto y van a salir muchísimos más talentos.
Y aparte, ve, por ejemplo, tú que estás en el área de marketing de la marca de Style Exchange, pues yo creo que podrías también tener, contemplar ese mercado, ¿no? El mercado latinoamericano, y no solamente como mercado, sino también como creadores en colectividad. Entonces, por ejemplo, Isa, que está ya trabajando con The Fabricant en la co-creación, y tiene también, obviamente, pues compañeros, porque es diseñadora, ¿no? Entonces, se pueden ahí como retroalimentar y se pueden ahí conectar y generar redes, para que así también la comunidad latinoamericana se vaya acercando, pero ustedes también habrán como canales en español.
Información, claro.
Sí, claro, totalmente. Yo creo que gracias a este espacio también muchas personas pudieron saber que hay una mexicana trabajando desde acá, y claro, todas nuestras puertas están abiertas para todos, y a mí me daría muchísimo, muchísimo gusto que más latinoamericanos se unan a nosotros y se unan al metaverso y a la moda digital.
Así que Isa, pasa la voz. Yo sé que aquí con lo que nos contó un poquito Pedro, de que tú pasas la voz, tú informas mucho a tus compañeros, a la gente que te rodea. Qué padre, sigue pasando la voz para que se creen esos lazos de conectividad, de información, de cultura, de aprendizaje y de búsqueda en este espacio tan intenso que cambia tan rápido. This is like a space that changes so fast. I cannot believe, I just like feel like so much pressure constantly that it's moving so fast. And then that you see on TV, like today in all the news, like the NFT market is crashing and that, and you're like, wait, stop it. So it's like very draining. So the fact that we can open a clear and sincere dialogue and be step by step and together, that's the most important element that we have in this community.
Pues sí, por supuesto que sí. Lo comento con mis compañeros. Y sí, o sea, me he dado cuenta de eso, de cuando de repente me meto a tus pláticas o las demás que existen, es una comunidad muy abierta, muy padre, y se puede solidificar muy bien, existe
tráelos, esa oportunidad. Que hagan un viaje de, así como se llama, viaje de campo o algo así, o sea, tráelos a un espacio para que sea
investigación de campo.
Pero que se vengan de corresponsables, de corresponsables al metaverso de Thalía.
Andrew, diles, véndeles la idea.
No, bueno, este espacio es el mejor metabarrio, la verdad. O
sea, sí, este si es no el aquí, metabarrio. Thalía, la del metabarrio. Tan, sí. tan. Así es. Pero mira, de verdad, creo que hemos tenido un gran espacio el día de hoy. Yo quiero pues cerrar con últimas palabras de todos. Y pues agradecerles por su tiempo, por su cariño, por su espacio, por sus conceptos, por educar a la comunidad y a todos los que están aquí escuchando, que están empezando a entender un poquito lo de este mundo. Recuerden que hagan su tarea, o sea, hagan su research, así como hay mucha gente queriendo ayudar, aquí también hay mucho vivo esperando a clavar el diente. Así que pónganse listos con todo lo que está alrededor. So, last words, okay? So, who's first? A ver, ¿quién vamos? ¿Con quién nos vamos? George, go.
Hey, I'm up. It's been a while. first off, I just want to say I'm a huge fan of Fabrican. And Pedro, I think what you guys are doing is incredible. I actually know Marco Marchesi. I think he's your CTO. Really brilliant guy. So very exciting what you guys are building. And I'm a big fan of Fabrican. So big shout out to you guys. I just want to say, everyone, thank you so much for inviting us. It's an honor always to talk about, you know, Colton Rain and the future of Web3 fashion. Appreciate everybody's time. Appreciate all the listeners tuning in. And I think the future is bright for all of us. So thank you very much, Thalía, for hosting us. You know, putting together such a beautiful forum of entrepreneurs and innovators. And looking forward to the future. Thank you.
Leo. Leo ya se durmió. He fell asleep. He's like, it's 2 a.m. here. Bye. I got enough.
Leo, wake up.
So you, last words. Bettina, yeah. Sierra.
English, Spanish.
Yes.
Leo, you go first.
Last
you
words. Last words.
I didn't fall asleep yet. I'm so with you guys.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
I don't know. Thank you guys for having us. Thank you guys for letting us share what we're building. If anyone out there wants to, you know, work, collaborate, bring their fashion into the metaverse, we're more than happy to help however we can. And everybody keep building, and let's build this metaverse of our imagination together.
Pedro.
Thank you, Thalía. Thank you, Rox and Antonio, for the invite. Thank you, George, also. And thank you, everyone here tonight, for joining this amazing conversation on the future of digital fashion. Well, inspire and get inspired by your surroundings.
Bravo, Pedro. Gracias, everyone. Thank you so much for your time. Rox, last words.
Thank you, Rox.
Thank you, George. So, thank you, everyone, for coming and joining us tonight.
The lawyer, Andrews, last words.
sin concediendo, sin suponer, diría el abogado. No, I just want to say, soy super fan de este espacio. I learned a lot. I am a fan of all the work that everyone here is building. You're putting yourself out there. No es fácil. Así es que muchas gracias por compartir y crear para un nuevo mundo y un mundo mejor.
Am I wrong?
No, you've been not wrong. But I want to say thank you to Thalía, and definitely to Rox, you know, for setting this up. And it was a wonderful conversation. And definitely look forward to seeing what the future has.
Thank you for putting this together. Thank you.
Thank you, China. Thank you.
Mil gracias, Talia y Rox.
Ay, thank you, Rox, mi amor. Thank you una vez más, my co-host y mi cómplice en esto. Despídase. So
we have a special announcement. First, the Wednesday coffee time space is going to be at 4 p.m. Eastern time, not 1 p.m.
Gracias a Dios bendito. Una que es Godín. Tenía yo que malabarear muy cañón.
And it's going to be at 4 because we have a special guest, Eva Longoria and Talia are going to have a conversation this Wednesday. So mark your calendars, set your reminders, and Eva Longoria and Talia Wednesday at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
And that's going to be on fire. That's going to be amazing. As you all know, we are so into Web3, into NFTs. We're moms, we're Latinas, we're like fun, and we cannot wait for our space together. Everybody, thank you once again. I'm so happy to share this platform with all of you, to build this community together. Love you so much. Have a wonderful rest of the week. And I'll see you in the next one.
See you in store.
Thank you.